are gods, we are kings. We march in faith cause we believe we can change the world to what it needs. Stand against our enemies cause we can. Kings demanding change cause we believe we can.
It don't matter if you put on some spandex and pretend like you're female. At the end of the day, you're a male. Read that again to both of those men down there. Read it again to those both of those brothers down there. Y'all in tremendous sin. Understand that. Don't think that because you put on some spandex and talk with a high voice that you have become a woman. You have not. You're still a man. Read it again.
Leviticus chapter 20 and verse 13. If a man also lie with mankind as he lieth with a woman.
You heard that, my brother? If one man lays down with another man, like it's a man and a woman, read.
Both of them have committed an abomination.
You heard that? Both men have committed an abomination. Both men have committed an abomination. You understand that? That's called the what? The pitcher and the catcher. The one who's doing it and the one who's receiving it. Both of y'all is in what? Grave sin. Just like anybody else who's what? Being a homosexual out here. We ain't gonna play with you. This is not America. This is God's law right here that we read it. We're not dealing with America's laws. We're dealing with God's law. Read it again.
If any man also lie with mankind as he lieth with a woman, both of them have committed an abomination.
That's called love right there. We just showed you love, brothers. For what? So y'all could come up out of that. You can't put on makeup to hide your beard, man. That's not going to happen out here. We're going to call it out. We're going to say you're a brother and act like that. The Lord said what? Grow your beard out. The Lord said do not be what? A homosexual. You can't cross-dress. You cannot cross-dress. Everything is out of order. We're not going to love you and say, oh yes, come to the church as you are. And God loves you. No, God hates you. Give me Sirach chapter 6 and 12 and 6. You know what I want. Because what you don't understand is that God hates sin and he hates the sinner. You see that? Y'all was told God hates the sin, but he loves the sinner. That's not what the Bible says. Read.
Sirach chapter 12, verse 6. For the Most High hateth sinners.
Who does he hate?
Sinners.
The Most High hateth sinners. Period. So when we talk about showing love, we showing you what the truth is in the Bible. We're not going to play with you. We're not going to hug you. We're not going to kiss you and say, brother, please, it's just, you must change. No, we're not doing that. Read it again.
For the Most High hateth sinners and will repay vengeance unto the ungodly.
You see that? He will repay what? Vengeance unto the ungodly. Give me Deuteronomy 28 and 64. Give me that. Because what y'all don't understand is that when you laying in these type of relationships, these homosexual relationships, you're going to get punished for this. 61 I want, sorry. You're going to get punished for this. Not because we said it, because God said it. Don't let them come with a little ad on the side of the bus. Oh, two men. Oh, you can have a marriage now. You're going to be in love with each other. No, God said, I'm going to repay you vengeance for that. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 61. Also, every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of this law, them will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed.
You heard that? The Lord said every sickness and every plague that is not written in this book of the law. What's not written in here? AIDS is not written in here. What's all the other diseases? Herpes, all of that. None of that is written in the Bible. The Lord said all the stuff, the diseases that's going to come, I'm going to deliver them to you because what? You broke the commandments. Until what? Until you be destroyed. So don't read these ads talking about, oh yeah, the HIV, it's undetectable. So don't worry about it. You can just have sex with another man and it's all good. No, that's called the devil right there. That's why when we tell you the white man is the devil, you don't want to believe it. But this is what we're trying to explain to you. Devil means what? Deceiver. That's what it means. If you have HIV, there's no way that it's going away. Undetectable meaning what? That what, you have sex with this person and you ain't gonna get it? If y'all are that stupid, then continue on and die to death. Read that again.
Also, every sickness and every plague, which is not written in the book of this law, them will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed.
Give me that thing in Romans 1. Go back to Romans 1. Because y'all think that when the Lord brings out these diseases, that somebody's going to be sad. The Lord said it's going to be good for them. He said, you want to be a homosexual, laid out with men, and I give you a disease, it's good for you. He's laughing about it. That's right.
And likewise, also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burn in their own lust, one toward another.
You heard that? That man did what? He left the natural use of a woman. He did not want to have sex with the woman. He didn't want to procreate with the woman. He did what? He took his own lust and had sex with a man, because you're not born gay. No one is born gay. I don't care where you go, who you see. Even inside, the scientists just came out with a report last week. So y'all can look this up, see if I'm lying. Go on Google, and the scientists that y'all believe in came out and said that there's no gay gene. No one is born gay. Go on. Keep reading that.
Men with men, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error which was meet.
You heard that? They got that recompense, that revenge from the Lord, which was meet, meaning which is good. So you want to break the Lord's commandments, you're going to get what you got coming. Same thing with you murderers. You want to murder? The Lord said, I'm going to put you to death. It's the same thing. Y'all accept that, right? Y'all accept that a man is killing a people and he get killed. So you're going to have to accept that the point is that the Lord said no homosexuality. You women who are lesbians, the Lord said, we don't give a damn about your feelings. The Lord said, I don't care about your feelings. Oh, the man hurt me. Now I'm going to lay with a woman. God said, hell no. It's not happening. Read that again.
And likewise, also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burn in their lust one toward another, men with men, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of the error which was meet.
You heard that? Give me verse 32 and I'm going to leave it right here. Let me tell you something about animal instinct. They follow the rules. You don't see a male dog mounting a male dog. You don't see that. You don't see the female going to the female, a cat having sex with a pigeon. You don't see none of that. Because they follow the commandments, because God already set that up in their brain. They're programmed. You, the Israelite, you got the devil on you. And guess what? Y'all following all the ways of the heathen. And that's why y'all running behind this garbage. Talking about it's the animal world. The animals do what the hell they supposed to do. Dogs is having sex with dogs. That's what they do. They don't look to the cat. Oh, let me go make a baby with a cat. That's never happened. Read.
Romans chapter 1 and verse 32. Who knowing the judgment of God, that they which commit such things are worthy of death.
You heard that? They which do such things are worthy of death. Understand that. Are we going to kill them? No. But the Lord said they're worthy of death. Huh? Exactly, bro. And this is the New Testament. Because they're trying to say, oh, there's the Israelites. They like reading the Old Testament. This is the New Testament. So your pastor should have brought this out in church with his gay choir leader. He gives him a position in the church. You're not supposed to have no position in the church when you're homosexual. You're supposed to be repenting out of that.
Right.
You got to change out of that because you can change. Don't let nobody tell you you cannot change. You can change. Read the rest of that.
Not only do the same, but have pleasure in them that do them.
You see that? The ones of you that say, hey, you know what? It's all good. Go ahead, y'all do y'all thing. The Lord said, y'all getting it too. Because you co-signing it. The Lord said, no, you don't co-sign this. You will not co-sign. You co-sign homosexuality, you going too. You're going also.
Yeah.
I'm a Jew, it's our art. For years I've been walking around saying that I'm a black man. I ain't saying that no more, it's our fault, man.
This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.